Hello, everyone. Welcome back. We're here for part three, where we're going to turn our attention to the vocal music component of surf rock. So again, to give us a little bit of orientation and to see where we're headed, let me go ahead and pull my lecture notes back up. So one thing that we're going to see here again is the same sorts of things in the guitar parts, most certainly. But now we're going to add a lyric component. And these lyric components are always going to be about three topics when it comes to surf rock. And that is either surfing, cars, or girls. And cars very specifically become a hot topic in, no pun intended, hot rod music that sort of splinters off after surf rock music experiences its decline. But before we get there, let's talk about, specifically the Beach Boys, because they were incredibly popular and well-known group. I'm sure you have heard one of the three tunes that I've listed about surfing below, either Surfin' Safari, Surfin' USA, or Surfer Girl. As you can tell by the titles, all are about surfing. The vocal styles that we have are going to be very jazz oriented, very much influenced by the vocal harmonies of the doo-wop movement, and even the girl bands that were in vogue in the 1960s. And, you know, surf rock ended up having a really profound impact on other genres that were running alongside in the 1960s, particularly the idea of putting greater importance on the instrumental component and adding a little bit more diversity and complexity to the harmonic language that's being used. So to jump right in, before jumping right in, I wanna talk a little bit about the demographic appeal. Mostly the people listening to surf rock outside of California were suburban white teenagers. And again, the movement was really popularized in California. So if you were living in California and even close to a beach, you could bet that surf rock was being played all the time on the radio. And that again is maybe something important to point out, is that consumption of music at this time does start to come into contact with travel and the idea that lots of people are driving cars in the 1950s and into 1960s, and cars are coming equipped with ways in which to play music. And the big thing that's going to come up is, of course, the radio. Before we have tape decks that are installed in vehicles, we do have early versions of record players and some older vehicles. But the idea is that the radio is going to have a huge impact on the transmission of music and what is part of the popular canon. To give us a little sound to identify what this vocal style is, I want to pull up our first surf-oriented or surf lyric-oriented example from the Beach Boys.
Serving you.
Another televised event where we have the Beach Boys in the spotlight. What's obviously really fun about this is we have a whole choreographed element of sort of surf-oriented moves, which were obviously popular on the dance floor as well. Not quite as comedic as these or sort of tableau-oriented, but nonetheless, you know, we have this full production here, and things that we hear in the instrumental component, you know, certainly existed in the other examples that we listened to. We have the Hammond organ, and instead of the jazz influence showing up in accompanying instruments, we hear it in the vocal harmony writing. And of any member of the Beach Boys, Brian Wilson was kind of the head of the group and in charge of, you know, a lot of their creative endeavors and putting things together. The harmonizing of certain parts, writing out their tunes, Brian Wilson was generally at the head of it. And to talk further about influences here, believe it or not, Surfing USA is also is almost a cover of Chuck Berry's tune, Sweet Little 16. And that obviously predates this surf rock piece and is a little bit more rock oriented in attitude. I wanna pull that up real quick.
Sweet Little 16.
They really rock it in Boston and Pittsburgh, PA.
The melody, it's pretty much straight lifted for Surfing USA. What's different here from Chuck Berry's performance is that we have the accompaniment is a little bit less even. It sounds like they are swung eighth notes. And that has a stronger tie to, you know, we talked about blues being a major influence on the initial rock genre. We can hear that in this. Another thing that we can hear is piano being used in the accompaniment. And that's obviously ditched in Surfing USA by the Beach Boys. Instead, we have a Hammond organ and these vocal harmonies that are incredibly rich. They actually do have a kind of like country twang to it, a little bit, yeah, that kind of pitch bending that happens in the vocal delivery of the lyrics. And instead here, we have something that sounds a little bit more kind of Elvis driven. And with that keyboard part that I was talking about, you know, piano being a commonplace instrument for the jazz genre, but we don't hear it at all in surf rock. So actually the Beach Boys, you know, Chuck Berry ended up being like, hey guys, like what, you pretty much stole my music. And every time that Surfing USA is, you know, used in something, Chuck Berry is also credited now as, you know, being a part of the original composition in a way. So that's cool. Copyright is important. So before leaving the Beach Boys, I want to play one more example of their music and also watch a short interview of them in the 1960s when they were popular. Brian Wilson and the Beach Boys continued on their journey as a group, really by diversifying their style after surf music, you know, fell out of popularity. So there's lots of documentary footage of Brian Wilson that deals with him later, 70s, 80s, 90s, etc. I don't want to look at any of that. I want to have you guys see this particular slice of history. So we're going to listen to the whole group in interview at the time that surf rock was important and popular. So before then, one more tune by the Beach Boys.
Thank you so very much. Thanks a million. Right now we'd like to do for you the first slow song the Beach Boys ever recorded. This one's a ballad called Surfer Girl.
So I love the women in the crowd going crazy for them singing this slow ballad. As you could possibly, or hopefully you heard, or you'll be able to make this connection later on, this has a lot of strong ties, this especially because it's down tempo, to what's happening in, you know, the 1960s Motown scene in Detroit. These rich vocal harmonies, especially at the slower tempo, we're able to elaborate on them a little bit more, dig into them as a primary feature. But we're doing this kind of within the genre of surf rock. It's certainly the least, I would say, surf rock sounding, aside from the kind of vocal inflections that we have that are trying to imitate some of the things that we hear in the guitar for the instrumental stuff. Before we leave the Beach Boys, and they're not the only representation of vocal music from the surf rock genre, I want to pull up the Beach Boys in interview as a group, televised in the 1960s. Okay, so for those of you who don't know a lot about television in the 1960s, there was, and actually a number of, you know, musicals and you know, films that are set in the 1960s refer to this television show by Dick Clark, and that was American Bandstand. And American Bandstand was also a huge venue in for which we hear the dissemination of popular music. And this is Dick Clark interviewing the Beach Boys in 1964.
Sure, most everybody knows, but for anybody who might not, may we introduce you by name?
Al Jardine.
Thank you, Al.
Dennis Wilson.
Thank you.
Brian Wilson.
And Carl Wilson.
Mike Love.
Now, I think, what happened? Yep. There you are. Four are related and one is a poor lost stranger. How did you get into this whole thing?
I'm a schoolmate of Brian's.
Oh, well, that worked it out well. So you are not a Wilson brother. He's a cousin on the end?
Yeah.
How long has this singing been going on?
About 3 years now.
You know, it's an amazing thing because you have hit after hit. Who determines, Brian, what will be done next?
Well, I guess I do. I don't know. I write the songs and produce them, so I have a lot to say about it.
Do you have a corporate setup? Does everybody have a vote? Can you vote him out and down if you don't like his idea?
Well, yes, we do, but he usually has good ideas.
He's the biggest one. That's all there is to it. No? You were recently overseas somewhere. You know, this is tough to interview five guys with one microphone. You work over here. Where were you when last seen? You told me, was it Australia?
Yeah, we just got back from Australia and New Zealand.
What do you find that's different and unusual about that country as compared to the USA?
Well, there's not too much of a difference, really, except they aren't quite as modernized as we are here. Their life isn't as fast-moving, you know, there's not as much TV and everything like that. And one thing I noticed, the radio disc jockeys there, they're kind of out of it.
They're not playing the latest things, but it takes a little while for the records to get there. Did you do any surfing while you were there? Is this possible?
Well, we got up at 6:30 every morning and got in about 2.
Really? And then you went to work?
One day of surfing with a newsreel, they wanted to see an American surfer, so...
Was it good, sir?
No, it wasn't. I thought it...
Sorry I asked.
I thought it would be good, you know, but it really wasn't as good as they said it was.
Brian, what is the summer hold? You're going to travel about the United States?
Yes, we have a tour. William Morris Agency is setting up a tour for about 3 to 4 weeks through the Midwest and down to Florida. I don't know where it's going.
Well, the word is to look for you as you travel about. What is the latest album called, please?
Fun, Fun, Fun.
All right, with the Beach Boys. It's kind of logical, isn't it?
No,
the latest one? No.
No, that's the latest thing.
Why doesn't somebody, you know,
to
fill him in? Fill him in.
The latest album is called Shutdown Volume 2.
You kind of shook me a little bit because you told me you had a different title. I thought, well, maybe he knows what I don't know. Fellas, this is your first visit to the bandstand. The autograph table is down to the left there. If you make yourselves comfortable, we'll join you there, okay?
So, again, interesting. So they're asked this question about surfing, but if memory serves, like one of them surfs, really. So interesting to have this genre of music that's tied to a sport that, you know, it's assumed that all the instrumentalists play this sport. It's pretty hard to surf. I'm from California myself. And even if you live on a beachside community, it, certainly now it's not expected that you surf. It's actually quite difficult. Vocal music wasn't was fairly dominated by the Beach Boys in terms of that surf music sound. But we do have one other representation of the vocal music genre that I do want to share with you, Jan and Dean. And they actually did a lot of crossover collaborations with the Beach Boys because they had a similar sort of style. They split at some point because record labels ended up getting kind of cross with them for doing too many collaborations. But I'm going to play for us as a way of closing out our third section. The Little Old Lady from Pasadena from 1964. And for those of you who don't know, Pasadena is certainly in California. This is a charming song, definitely different from the Beach Boys in style. An old lady and a car. She's driving around and not fast enough. I love that we have those same kind of vocal characteristics that we have from our backup singers that makes an appearance in very strongly in the Beach Boys. In terms of sound, though, it's significantly louder than some of the other things that we've heard. It has a whole horn section, and that's an exciting, more dynamic approach to the supporting ensemble than we've perhaps heard, which makes a big deal out of guitars, and it seems like guitars alone, and sometimes a Hammond organ. But in this case, we have a whole horn section, and horn sections were big in the big band tradition. So just some interesting intersections when we're listening to music of this genre. All right, for our fourth and final section, we're going to talk about the decline of the genre, revivals that have happened of surf rock, and then surf rock imitations that are happening in the UK and in the rest of Europe, but particularly the UK. And the UK ends up effectively stomping out almost all genres of rock and roll when we have the British invasion that really starts in 1964 with the Beatles. Not many groups end up you know, surviving the wake of that huge force of nature. But in any case, I will see you for part 4 shortly.